From where you are, you see the smoke start to arise where they play cards. As you walk over, moving softly past the guards. Ooh, the stakes are getting higher, you can feel lead in your heart. He calls you bluff, he is the ace, you never thought he'd play that much. But now it's more than just his cards you want to touch. Ooh, you never know if willing this could really be. Now as he starts to leave the room, you see the stars. And when you walk around, you know the room by heart. I cannot believe it, I have never seen a night like this. I cannot believe it, I have never seen a night like this. How many times have I been sitting by the door to hear these chimes, to know that someone debonair has just arrived and opened up the world before my very eyes. That silhouette creates an image of a night I can't forget, but now it's something, baby, I know I can't rest. You never know.
Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, honoured guests, welcome to the 2021 European Athletics Golden Tracks Awards live from Lausanne, Switzerland, and welcome to those of you who are watching around the world on our live stream. That was Four for the Blues, starting with A Night Like This, and I'm delighted to say that we'll be hearing more from them later in the evening. Now, tonight, there will be two top-class athletes presenting the show. And firstly, I have the pleasure of welcoming Swiss legend, European indoor and outdoor champion, on the flat and over the hurdles, it is, of course, the wonderful Lea Sprunger, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Andy. Thank you very much for having me tonight. And I'm looking forward for a great show.
It is going to be a great show. It's wonderful to have you with us. And incidentally, when we were rehearsing, and I know that's going to come to as a bit of a shock that we do actually rehearse for this show, we worked out that we have exactly the same personal best of 50.52 seconds.
We do, Andy. That must have been a tough 200, right?
It was a tough 200, cheeky. our second presenter, I mentioned there were two athletes. You may have already guessed that I'm not the second one. But our third presenter absolutely is a GB long jumper, European silver medalist, and twice an Olympic finalist. Would you please welcome to Lausanne, Jasmine Sawyers, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey. Hi.
Great to have you here for what is your second time presenting these awards.
Thank you, Andy. It's an absolute treat to be back here in Lausanne, and even better to have Lea with us this time. An extra pair of hands to keep Andy under control is always welcome.
Could be quite important. I'd like to welcome all 50 member federations of European Athletics who are with us in Lausanne, and also mention our social media wall, which will be appearing behind us. If you want to send a tweet, if you want to send a picture, If you're in the venue here, you can connect to Wi-Fi. Instructions are on your table. If you're at home, I'm sure you know how to connect to your own home Wi-Fi. Please do, and use the hashtag GoldenTracks. That's GoldenTracks. Please do keep it clean. We'd like to thank our hosts here tonight, European Athletics, of course, based here in Lausanne. Many of you will know Lausanne well, but here's a small introduction of our host city for our broadcast audience. Well, some beautiful pictures there of Lausanne. It really is a pleasure to be here, and also a pleasure to introduce our first speaker to the stage.
Here to welcome us to this year's Golden Track Award is the European Athletics President, Dobromir Karamarinov.
Now, let's first of all get one thing straight. Mr. President, I can call you Mr. President now, correct?
Of course, you can remove interim.
Excellent, excellent. Now, here we are at the Golden Tracks. How does it feel to be back on this stage after we were forced to cancel last year's event?
Yes, it's a big pleasure to be together in person. 2020 was a terrible, unpredictable, difficult year, but now we are together. You remember, a year ago from here in Lausanne, but I was alone. All these 50 member federations was in the screen, but I promised to them that we'll be back to the track. We'll be back, and we succeed together. I want to thanks to our member federation. It was three hard days. We had a congress, we had convention, we have many workshops. Thanks to all the delegates from the member federation. Thanks to the European Athletics staff, thanks to our partners. Sepp, special thanks to you. You were with us from the first day until now. And I'm excited. Now it's time for celebration.
You mentioned 2020 being such an awful year. 2021 has been very different. We still have problems, but it's been a very different year. Given that, what are you looking forward to tonight?
For tonight, as I said, it's time for celebration, but 2021 was a really successful year. We start with the Torun Indoor Championships, and after then all the leagues, very successful Super League team championships. And we, even that it's all so difficult, but we can manage our under-20, under-23 championships back-to-back in Tallinn. It was a really successful year. And now in celebration time, our Rising Star, our Athletes of the Year, they're here. It will be a really exciting moment to celebrate with them.
I hope you have a good evening, Mr. President. Ladies and gentlemen, Dobromir Karamarinov. Well, now we get straight on with the show and the first award of the night, the Women's Leadership Award.
The Women's Leadership Awards were created in 2009 to recognize and celebrate women leaders in the sport of athletics. The main criterion is a significant contribution that serves as an example of leadership and other values of the sport of athletics. And here are this year's winners.
Here to present one of the Women's Leadership Award in person is European Athletics Council member Karin Grootemovin.
Thank you. Well done to all women leadership winners. This year, I'd like to invite Anna Krestova of North Macedonia onto the stage to receive the first of the awards and the artwork, piecework on behalf of all the nation winners, to date in local ceremonies organized by their own member federations.
Thank you very much indeed.
Good evening, everyone. I'll be really short. I wouldn't be here tonight if it wasn't for the army of women that dedicate their life to the sports of athletics every single day. I am honored and privileged to be here as a representative recipient of the Women's Leadership Award. Thank you, European Athletics, for honoring and acknowledging all the women in our sport. Thank you, World Athletics, for being the power, force, and inspiration to all the women. And last but not least, thank you to my president, Alexandra, for recognizing me, encouraging me, and giving me freedom to be the best version of myself. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, Anna. Thank you, Karen. Applause for all our winners as they make their way off the stage. Now on to an award that recognizes and celebrates our member federations. This award is given on an annual basis to individuals who've dedicated a number of years' service to their national federation, to European athletics, or to the sport in Europe. This honour is given to leaders, event organisers and coaches, as well as other worthy recipients proposed by the presidents of their national federations.
Please welcome European Athletics CEO Christian Miltz and World Athletics President Sebastian Coe to the stage as we look at the winners from all member federations.
Congratulations to all the winners. This year, one person from Ireland has been invited to be the first to receive awards on behalf of all the national winners. Please welcome on stage Georgina Germ.
Thank you very much indeed, Mr. President. Thank you, Georgina. Congratulations on your award. If you could just stay with us for a second. Seb is staying as well. But a round of applause for Georgina and all our national winners.
And now, on to the coaching award. And here's a video with the names of all the European Athletics Coach Awards winners.
European Athletics Coaching Awards celebrate the important contributions made by so many coaches to the sport of athletics.
This year, the coach of each Olympic champion is automatically nominated, and in total, 56 coaches will receive this important and prestigious award.
Good evening. And I'm delighted to welcome to the stage Hans-Rudi Kunz of Switzerland to collect his award and also to act as representative of all the coaching winners. The rest of the recipients will receive their awards and will be honoured at national ceremonies in their own countries.
Stand slightly sideways so they can take a picture of you. There we go. Thank you very much indeed.
I would like to thank you very much for this great honor. I think it's not only an honor for me, for myself, it's also an honor for the multiple events. I am perhaps not the best coach, but probably I'm the coach who did his job very long. I started coaching 1973 in the club. I was also at this time the national coach in decathlon. And last year, at the end of last year, I stopped with coaching, not in the club, but as a national coach. And as long as I like to coach and I have good athletes who are interested to perform or to be better, and as I am healthy and fit, I think I will continue. Thank you very much.
Well, a congratulations to all the recipients of the Coaching Award. I have moved down onto the floor because you can't have failed to have noticed our now famous social media wall, which I'm sure we'll see in a moment. It's populated with comments from all around Europe about our awards tonight. And speaking of social media, let's meet a very familiar face to EA's social media channels, Miss Ola Wiesel. Ola, welcome tonight. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Jasmine. Good evening, everyone.
Well, I say thank you for coming. You had to come and post some things on the EA social media channels. You are our social media guru, and we know these days how important social media can be. So I wanted to ask you a piece of advice for people looking to grow their channels, athletes and federations alike.
So what I'm doing is basically I'm creating content for two groups of people. Athletes, so the stars of my content, and followers. So if I could give one advice, it would be build trust. Because you have to put yourself in someone's place. So ask yourself, would you like to be recorded by someone who you know, by a friend, and you know that she won't post anything against you? Or would you like to be recorded by a total stranger? And would you like to follow someone who's actually giving you the opportunity to engage in the content and be a part of the organization, but part of European athletics? Or would you like to follow someone just because he or she has nice pictures or videos?
I think that's perfect advice, and any of you that have been following along with Ola's work on the EA social channels will know that she does feel like a friend. And if you haven't seen it, then I think it's time you started following.
Well, it's a great thing, social media. It's really important for our sport, but it's even more important for my personal collection. So I'm just going to take a quick photo of the two of you. That's great. Thank you
very much. Andy, can we see it? In fact, if you post it, it'll come up on the wall. Can you
hashtag
post that
golden
in? Because I want to see if we look golden good tonight.
Tracks. Christian, I've just sent you the picture. Is there any chance you could get that up for us?
Ah.
Ah, yeah.
I have to say, Ola, I think we've looked better.
Yeah, I think
so. Not sure that's the right one, but I am available for private hire. Thank you very much indeed, Ola. Thank you so much, Jasmine.
Ola.
Let's get back to some proper pictures now and take a look at this year's European Athletics big events.
What a year. Obviously, we love to celebrate winning, but sometimes winning can happen off the track, and acts of compassion are even more important than securing medals, especially when lives are at stake. And that was certainly the case for Polish javelin thrower Maria Andrzejczak.
During my medal ceremony, when I put the medal on my neck, I realized that, okay, fine, I'm silver Olympic medalist, that's cool. But it's done. I actually don't need that medal because I know the real value of my medal and it will stay in my heart for forever. So I thought that I don't need to keep that medal just to collect dust in a closet. That's why I decided to put that medal for auction. And the Miłoszek fundraising was the first fundraising I found on the internet. And I knew that it will be the last one, the only one. But when I read the story about his problems with heart, I decided to give that medal exactly to Miłoszek. I just wanted to help in saving his life, that's all.
For her incredible gesture, yes, indeed. You're going to need to clap again in a second, because for her incredible gesture, we would like to award Maria with our special European Athletics Community Award. Let's hear it again, please, for Maria. Maria.
No, you don't. You don't have to.
You're okay. You're safe. You're done.
And now we are to move on to the main part of this evening, where we honour the very best athletes that Europe has to offer, starting with the two most promising athletes for the future. Please welcome European Athletics Vice President Libor Vahanek to announce the finalists.
Good evening. It's an honor to present the award for Women's Rising Star of 2021 here at the Golden Track Awards in Lausanne. The finalist are Rasidas Adeleke, Femke Bol, and Kelly Hutchinson. And the winner is Femke Hutchinson. Femke Bol.
If I could just have a brief word, I'll come around this side, don't worry, I'll come around this side. You're not very important now, Liebel, you've done the award.
I'll be sitting next to him.
Okay, never mind. The evening will get better, don't worry. You're a rising star, you're only 21, but you've just done so much. How have you achieved so much at such a young age?
I think I've run a lot this year, so that helped for sure. But I just train really hard with my coaches at Papendal and with an amazing team without Lea next year, unfortunately. But I think we just push each other all to a higher level every single day.
You started the year really strongly and it kept going. What was the secret to your consistency?
I think just staying calm and keep having confidence. From every good race, you get more confidence, and it just helped me throughout the entire year.
And the success you had at indoors, did that give you the confidence to approach the outdoor season as you did?
Yes, for sure, because I found out I was really strong, and I just went out with hurdles like I never went before, and I died a bit with the leg dip, but I dare to do that now, finally.
And, you know, I was lucky enough to interview you in Stockholm at the Diamond League. Every Diamond League, you're sort of being paraded as one of the major names, the big stars. Is that something you enjoy?
It's new, and I'm getting a bit used to it. But, yeah, it's really nice that people like it that you're there. And I just always try to put my best race, especially at Diamond Leagues, of course. And I really enjoy all those meets, so I'm always happy to be there.
Well, let's talk about your best race. I mean, what a race. Olympic bronze medalist, area record. Just take me through the race, not from gun to tape, but just how did you approach it? How did you feel during it? And how elated were you at the end?
I think we approached it by just trying to win. I knew the other two Americans were really strong, so I would just try to be with them with 300 meters. So I went out like crazy. And then I died a bit of the leg dig, but when I was over the finish, I realized I became third, and it was crazy. And then when I saw my time, it was even, I first saw their time, of course, and it's really inspirational, and then my own, and it's, I still sometimes cannot really believe it.
Well, we can believe it. We are just so proud to have you as one of our European stars. You're our European rising star. You're going to go on to so many more things. I know you are. Ladies and gentlemen, please, Femke Bol. Thank you very much, and thank you, Liebel.
Congratulations, Femke, and to all of our other finalists. Now, there is, of course, another Rising Star Award, and here to present it, newly elected European Athletics Vice President, Jean Gracia.
Thank you. Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here for the Men's Rising Star of the Year. This year's finalists are Christian Tse, Alessandro Sibilio, and Sasha Zoya. And the winner is Sasha Zoya.
Sasha, we want to have a little word with you, if that's all right. Congratulations.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
A few questions for you. You broke twice the world record in less than 24 hours. That's pretty amazing. How did that feel?
I felt good. It felt good. It was something that I've been chasing for a long, long time. So finally getting it at the end of my season as well, felt accomplished, yeah.
You're the kind of athlete that people like to watch. You know, you put on a show for us. Are you having as much fun out there as it looks like?
I'm having fun at the competition, but at the training, it's a lot less fun. So I'm trying to appreciate the competition and, you know, have a bit of banter, have a bit of fun. But there's no fun at training, so if people want to have a go, have a talk to coach, he's over there, so make sure that my training's a little bit more fun, it would be good.
No fun at all?
Nah, not much, yeah, not much.
Next year's pretty big, and you're coming off the back of a giant year, huge year. Best has ever been of your age, that's pretty impressive. What's next for you? What are you looking for next year?
Well, next year I go into the senior rank, so I get to take on the best of the best. Age is no longer a number, and I'm on the senior height of hurdles. So it's going to be a challenge, but I'm someone who looks forward to challenges, so hopefully it can go well.
Have you already started practicing on the higher heights?
Oh, absolutely. You have to start early.
Well, congratulations again. Thank you for chatting to us. Sasha Zoya, everybody.
Well, congratulations to both our rising stars of 2021. We're going to take a very small break from the awards, but time for some more musical entertainment now from Four for the Blues. Once again, with singer Janet Dawkins. Enjoy.
My baby don't care for shows. My baby don't care for clothes. My baby just cares for me. Ooh, my baby don't care for cars and races. My baby don't care for hot tone places. Liz Taylor is not his style, and even Lana Turner smile. Well, it's something he can't see. It's something he can't see. My baby don't care. Who knows it? My baby just cares for me. Thank you. clothes, and he don't even care for shows. He just cares for me. Woo, my baby don't care for cars and races. Baby don't care for, don't care for high tone places. Liz Taylor is 90s style, and even Liberace smile. Well, there's something he can't see. There's something he can't see. My baby don't care, who knows it? My baby just cares for, my baby just cares for, baby just cares for me. Yeah.
Nancy, thank you. The next song we're about to perform is Route 66.
Thank you very much indeed once again to Four for the Blues and to Janet. Now, next year promises to be extra special as we head to Jerusalem, to Munich and to Turin. Here's a taster of what we can expect in 2022.
I tell you what, watching that makes me so excited for next year. I want to go put my spikes on already. All three of those events look like they're going to be fantastic. I'm particularly excited about the European Championships in Munich after having had a great time in Berlin in 2018. Somebody else that had a great time in Berlin 2018 is Anita Voracek, who is here next to me. Are you looking forward to Munich next year?
Yes, good evening. Yes, I am ready to European Championships in next year. It will be to me 6 European Championships. Yes, the first in 2010 in Barcelona.
Well, I wish you all the very best. I'm sure you'll have just as much success as you've had previously. And I know that I had a great time with the crowds in Germany, and so I'm sure they'll bring the same energy next time. Now, 2022 is exciting to look forward to, but we have plenty still to celebrate from 2021. Leah, tell us what's next.
Now to the last part of tonight's show, the Athlete of the Year Award. Here to present the Male Athlete of the Year is European Athletic President Dobromir Karamarinov.
It's my pleasure, a big honor, to announce the finalists for the Male Athletes of the Year. Arvan Duplantis, Lamont Marcel Jacobs, and Karsten Rolholm. The winner is Karsten Rolholm.
Carson, if I can have a quick word, here we are again.
Yeah.
That race, I've been lucky enough to listen to that race commentary in about 4 or 5 different languages. Didn't understand everything that was said, but I understood the last word that everybody did say, and that last word was, wow. Did you realize as that race was unfolding just what was happening?
I love that you're saying it, because I've watched the race in a lot of languages as well, and the thing is, the only thing you can hear is the enthusiasm. You know, I don't listen to the word, I just hear the enthusiasm. And for me, it's been very hard to digest, because it's a new level in the event. But, you know, I'll take it. I think it was good.
Yeah, we'll all take it, for sure. Probably a ridiculous question, but I'm going to ask it anyway. What have you got that nobody else has?
Whoa. I don't know, man. But what I want to say is, and this is what I find interesting, because I've been doing this for quite a while, and I started with my first World Championship gold medal in London in 2017. I ran 35, I think. And from there on, every year I've been thinking, now I've done everything that I can do to be the best athlete that I can be. Every year I find another thing that I can do. And now I'm living a very strict life, because I know what it takes to be on that level. So right now, I think what drives me is the passion. And I think passion is, you know, what probably most of all of us here have. We have a passion for the sport and have a passion for developing.
You certainly have passion, but you also have showmanship. Now, people say that sport needs characters, athletics needs characters. Do you think you are a character, and do you enjoy being a character if indeed you are one?
It's funny because I actually met Usain Bolt only 2 weeks ago, and I said to him, you're super lucky because you had your thing. You could just do like this or whatever, but me, I haven't thought that far. I just get over the finish line and I win, and like, what do I do now? So, you know, it's always a big surprise what I'm going to do when I cross the finish line. But if I'm a character or not, you know, it's hard to tell. It's something that we focus a lot on, but for me, it's mostly about performance. And if, you know, being myself is something we can look at as being a character, that's probably good. But I'm here for the results, and yeah, hopefully I can bring some personality to it. But it's not something I put a lot of energy into.
I look forward to seeing that first celebration when it happens.
That's you want me to rip my shirt or just walk down?
Let's do that later after a couple of glasses of wine.
Okay,
we are live around the world at the moment.
Oh shit!
Yeah, yeah, we are live around the world at the moment. No! Come back. Haven't finished. Haven't finished. One last question. Diamond League champion, world record, Olympic gold medalist, is there any fibre of your body that every now and again goes, I've done it now, I can relax, or is that not the Vorholm way?
I'll tell you a funny story, because I woke up the day after the final in Tokyo, and then my coach, Leif, he comes into the room and say, you know, next thing is 44. And I'm like, I just need one day break. But I think I always think that I can do something better, but it's going to be very difficult from now. But I love doing this sport, and it's a lot of people, especially in Norway, that ask me, you know, you should be unmotivated and want to quit. But, you know, I'm more motivated than ever. It's like, if a company has their best year ever, you don't shut down the company. You keep on going, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I know you're going to keep on going. It's been such an honor and a pleasure to watch you this year. You're also rocking that black shirt, black tie combo. Good man.
You and me both.
Yeah, absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest athletes Europe has ever produced, Carsten Vorholm. Thank you, Dobromir.
Before we move on to the very last award of the show, a moment of introspection. Something a bit special in honor of our European heroes from the Tokyo Olympics, with a little help from David Bowie.
Dolphins can swim, and nothing will keep us together. We can beat them forever and ever. We can be heroes just for one.
nothing would fall. We can be heroes just for one day. We can be us, yeah, just for one day. High, just for one day.
Wow, that was inspiring and emotional, and a bit scary. Thanks to our band, to Janet and our two acrobats, Maud and Julia. And I'm delighted to say that some of the athletes in the video are with us tonight. Your applause, please, for Carsten Warholm.
Pedro Pablo Pichardo.
Wojciech Nowicki.
David Tomala.
Karol Zaleski.
Kajetan Duszynski.
And last but not least, Anita Wodarczyk.
It really is wonderful to have you with us on this very special night. Let's move on then to our last award of the evening, the Women's European Athlete of the Year Award. And here to present that is European Athletics Vice President, Cherry, the one and only Alexander.
Thank you, Andy. Good evening. It's a great honour to present this award. The finalists for the Women's Athlete of the Year are Sifan Hassan, Maria Lyaskeni, and Anita Wolodarczyk. And the winner is Sifan Hassan.
Unfortunately, due to some last-minute unforeseen circumstances, Sifan isn't able to make it here to be with us tonight. But she did send us this video message.
Hello. I hope everyone is doing well over there. Unfortunately, I'm not able to join you in Geneva. I'm really thankful for this award. I would like to thank Europa Athlete for this great attempt. Also my coach, my management, my family, all fans around the world for supporting me throughout this fantastic season. I hope to see you soon in real life. For now, I wish you a wonderful evening.
Here to accept the award on Sifan's behalf is the president of the Dutch Federation, Eric van der Berg.
That's a long walk, Eric. Sifan would have done it much quicker.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Thank you very much indeed for collecting the award. In fact, you can stay with us if you wouldn't mind just for a second, because I just want to say we're nearly at the end, but please do keep your tweets coming. Hashtag Golden Tracks. We'd love to see your efforts up on the social media wall. But that pretty much does conclude our evening.
A huge thank you to everyone here and to those you watching around the world.
And again, congratulations to all of tonight's finalists and especially to our winners, all of whom we would like to invite back up onto the stage, along with our European Olympic champions. So if you could please join us back on the stage.
And let's have a round of applause again, please, for all of our winners and our Olympic champions. If they join us on the stage, please come and join us for one last photo opportunity. Also, while we're still in the clapping mode, could I thank our two amazing co-hosts? Let's hear it for Jasmine Sawyers and for Leah Sprunger, ladies and gentlemen. Don't be shy, come on up. We want one really great photograph with you all on stage. But seeing us out tonight is Four for the Blues with There Is No Greater Love. Enjoy the rest of your evening. From Jasmine, from Leah and myself, Andy Kay, have a great time. Good night. Thank you.
in a mellow tone, feeling fancy free. I am not alone, I've got company. Everything's okay, the live long day with this mellow song. I can't go wrong in a mellow tone. That's the way to live if you mope and groan. Something's got to give. Just go your way, laugh and play. There's joys unknown in a mellow tone. Yeah, in a mellow tone. Well, I'm feeling fancy free. I am not alone, I've got company. Everything's okay, the live long day with this mellow song.